here tonight to talk about a couple of things, right? First and foremost, of course, is the townhouse itself. That's why we're here. But it's impossible for me to actually talk about sort of the union of the technology that I've been working on and sort of your ability to draw light into townhouses without first talking a little bit about the project that generates the whole idea. It's called the Lowline, and as Dexter says, it's an initiative that I'm involved in, that I created, to create the world's first underground park. Underneath the Lower East Side, under Delancey Street, there is an abandoned trolley terminal that's about 60,000 square feet. And the idea is that we can use these sorts of advanced optical technologies to really effectively turn light into a liquid, channel it down underground, redistribute that light, and turn it into a green public space filled with trees, grass, etc. You're filtering out infrared, you're concentrating light, you're sending it, in this case, through a fiber optic cable to a distribution system which re-spreads it back out. It's an ancient space. It was built between 1903 and 1908, formerly the Williamsburg Trolley Terminal. And it's vaulted, cobblestoned, and sort of filled with all of the old historical details that you might expect of a space that age. It's at a very important location, and so this is actually not only a technological and a design project, but also sort of a love letter and hopefully a legacy for New York City as a whole. So you can channel natural sunlight. You can't keep it, you can't save it, but at the same time, you can just redirect it with very little loss, actually, to a completely separate location. And you've delivered something very important to all of us. As, you know, sort of our forebears who built all these townhouses recognized, there's just something about natural light. Natural light has a really profound effect on, you know, the way that we see color, the way that we sort of see each other, the way that we see art, just our general moods. You know, it's a very powerful thing to mess with. It also happens to grow plants, which was one of the very first realizations that I had when I thought of applying this technology to that old trolley space. We wanted to create this sort of fantasy, magical landscape underground. And so to do that, we studied very carefully sort of what the luminance ratios were between direct sunlight and the sky, and sort of how you actually might begin to sort of balance the ratios of those things to recreate some of the effects that actually are producing the feeling of the natural outdoors. Because at the end of the day, you know, we can harvest light as a blunt instrument, but the actual use of that light and sort of the finesse by which you actually apply it is something of an art. Once you begin to apply this kind of technological idea to a space like this, the results are actually kind of astounding. It was a really sort of eye-opening project that opened up a lot of possibilities as to what we could do with design and technology. In a typical New York townhouse, it is the ultimate living scenario in my mind, and I personally aspire to one someday, but it does have a few drawbacks, and you know, these have been addressed in any number of ways historically and potentially in the future, right? And I guess that's the meat of what I'm here to talk about. The thing that I think is worth noting is that, you know, with almost all of these, you have windows at two ends, and that's it, right? The net effect of what happens there is that, okay, number one, you're 60 feet away from your rear neighbor, right? And oftentimes a lot less, right? You're on a, oftentimes, you're usually on what's called a narrow street in sort of New York zoning parlance, right? And everything's casting a shadow on you. There's usually tons of awesome sycamores in your, like right in front of your house too, casting shadows on you too. And so you end up in a situation where, especially on your lower floors, and definitely in that English basement, it's pretty dark. Oftentimes, we do need to look to artificial sources to make it not such a bleak landscape down there, right? It's a hell of a lot of shadow on this image, and you know what? It's in those spaces as well. And even if you do something like have an awesome glass wall in the back of your place or whatever, unless your address is on the south side of the street, you know, you are probably not getting any direct light whatsoever. Into your townhouse via that means. You're getting light that radiates from the sky, you're getting reflected light, etc., but not any direct light. And typically in a traditional townhouse also, usually the stair carriage is not actually open, right? It's usually walled off. So you may be getting all this light in the world coming through your skylight if you're lucky, but it's definitely not going into sort of the core. Increasingly, we have the need for maybe to examine new solutions to how we might begin to bring natural light into spaces. Can get the color temperature adjusted for all sorts of things, right, and have it suit all sorts of needs. But at the end of the day, there's something fundamentally kind of missing from most types of light. And it's something that natural sunlight is able to supply. And like I said earlier, it satisfies something I think, that you know, some sort of deep psychological need within us. This is a company called Sunlight Direct that made sort of a very large version of what I had made. Effectively, you can concentrate light down into a fiber optic cable and lead it to where you need. Heliostats, that's how they light that little pocket park in Battery Park. This is a collimating system that can be applied to a facade. This effectively allows you to collect direct sunlight and aim a perfectly collimated means parallel ray still, right? Shaft of light to wherever you need it, always, right? And so this is something that tracks and follows the sun. Also a particularly effective means of harvesting light for residential application. And onto this one, which is most similar to the methodology we employ in the Lowline, in which you can actually use a heliostat in combination with a concentrating system to effectively send light through, you know, something akin to a plumbing riser, right? And so you send it wherever you want in your house, send it to where you need it to go, and then from there it's the art of how you want to distribute all of this light that you have. And just for reference, by the way, sunlight on a natural day is 1,000 times brighter than this, right? And so even if you lose half of that sunlight in the process of sending it through an optical system, it's more than you know what to do with. And so I just, you know, I think that that's something to keep in mind as you think about methods of actually drawing in natural direct sunlight into a space. And once you've done that, there's all sorts of ways that you can begin to distribute that sort of super concentrated light throughout your space, be it actually something that just kind of looks like a normal light fixture, to all the way to just doing something where it's a polycarbonate tube that actually serves as a diffuser, or for that matter, to the way that we had tightly controlled it in order to produce a very specific effect. There is no sort of magic bullet. I know that you all were hoping to hear about a magic bullet, but there isn't really one. It's more of an art form, and it's an emerging art form. I think that there's all sorts of methods that you can employ, but as for which one is going to work best for you and your townhouse, it requires actual study and sort of the application of a little bit of technical knowledge to actually figure that out. So sorry about that. I would encourage you, if you have any inclination though, to please come and check out what the work that we are doing on the Lowline. It's not only directly applicable to each of your houses, but I think it's something that hopefully is close to anyone's heart who is from New York or loves this city. You know, it's an attempt to do something with design and technology to make our city a little bit better. So, all right, thank you. Thank you.